everyone, and welcome to my channel. So today I am going to be unboxing my Universal Yums subscription box for the month of September. So if you're unfamiliar with Universal Yums, they are a foreign food snack subscription box that is going to send you snacks and treats from around the world. So Universal Yums does have three different subscription boxes. They have the Yum Box, the Yum Yum Box, and then they have the Super Yum Box. So the Yum Box sends you 5 to 7 snacks and retails for $17 a month. The Yum Yum Box sends you 10 to 12 snacks and retails for $29 a month. And then they also have the Super Yums box, which is the box that I have right here. You get 15 to 18 snacks and it does retail for $45 a month. The price of the box does get a little bit cheaper if you commit to a longer subscription length. And I will also have a referral code down below that will get you $5 off of your first box. And if you love subscription boxes like I do, go ahead and subscribe to my channel. But otherwise, we're going to go ahead and dive into this box. But I will also add that I am not going to be trying any of the snacks. This is just a video to give you an overview of what is in the box. If you are looking for somebody who is trying the snacks, I might not be the best video for you, but if you just want a quick overview of what you would get in the box, then you are in a pretty good spot. So their box is packaged very nicely. When you open it, it says, "Welcome to South Korea," which is going to be the country for September. On the back, it does have all the items listed, and you can rate them favorite, worst, and weirdest. Take a picture of this, upload it to social media. You have a chance to win extra snacks. They do also just have some extra information about South Korea. There is also going to be a little booklet in the box, which is one of my personal favorites. So it will tell you things about South Korea. There's also some trivia that you can answer. And then it tells you about each item in the box. And if you are interested, there are also some nutritional facts in the back. Yes, there they are. And there's also some recipes, which I think is always very cool. There is also a sticker, so it'll say a little spot for you to put your name, travel to South Korea, and the Yums were really popping. They used to include these on the box as like one of the sticker labels, but now they just put them in your box, which I think is nice. And then you do have all of your goodies. So there are a ton of items in here and they look delicious. And one last thing about Universal Yums, I just want to give a huge shout out to their customer service because I am posting this video a little bit later in the month, and that is because my first box somehow disappeared. It left the Universal Yums facility. It was on its way to UPS and the tracking never updated. And I waited about a week, 10 days before I reached out to Universal Yums. I sent them an email. They looked at the tracking, no questions asked. They automatically sent me a brand new box because they said my first one was missing. So I really do appreciate that they were really quick to help me with my issue, sent a new box out within a day or two, and now I have my replacement box. So definitely a huge shout out to Universal Yums. But first up in the box is going to be a sweet item. This is a marshmallow choco pie. It's South Korea's border hopping delicacy. This looks pretty good. It says it also has black sugar milk tea. I don't know if that's what the flavor of it is, but that's definitely a unique one. So that's pretty cool. Ooh, switching it up with something spicy. These are spicy chicken flavored corn puffs. Sweet and spicy snacks with a serious crunch. I remember trying these. So I've been subscribed to Universal Yums for probably 3.5 years now. So I have had one of their South Korean boxes before. Universal Yums does not have repeat boxes too often, but of course at some point they will have to repeat a country. So they do throw in some new items, but they also have some past favorites. And I remember enjoying this a lot. It was not super spicy, but I'm really excited to see this again. And from flipping through this booklet, I see there are some items that I remember loving in the first South Korea box. Okay, this is pretty cool. This is mascarpone filled shortbread cookies, light crispy cookies with a subtle cream filling. I love mascarpone things. I mean, I've never really had it on its own, but I love it in cannolis. So I am just so excited to give that a try. Another sweet item, it's a sweet and sour chew. So they're grape flavored chews inspired by the grape festival. That's pretty cool. They do feel very soft too, which I think is a huge plus. Moving on to some shrimp chips. That's very unique. Crunchy, airy snacks made with real shrimp. Huh. That's pretty cool. I wonder what they taste like. I love the little shrimp on the packaging too. It's just so cute. But okay. There is some peach flavored gummies. This is a peach a day keeps the ghosts away. There must be a little bit of a story behind that. The juicy springtime fruit is said to repel spirits. The branches are even used in exorcisms. Okay, that's definitely interesting. These look really good though. I love the gummies that have like the liquid center. These look so tasty. There's a lot of sweets in here and I'm all for that. So this is cookies and cream flavored cookie sticks. I love cookie sticks and cookies and cream. You cannot go wrong with that. Number one brand in Korea. I don't think I've ever heard of this brand, but it looks very tasty. What is this? Bulgogi flavored noodle snack. Smash sprinkle snack. Are they actually noodles? Interesting. Don't boil it, smash it. So this honestly feels like a ramen noodle pack in here. What does it say about it? How to enjoy. Take out the spices and smash noodles. Sprinkle spices, shake and enjoy. Huh. This is very unique, but it's crazy. I mean, it actually feels like a ramen noodle pack. So this is very unique. I'm excited to give this a try. I'm pretty sure I've had these before, and I remember enjoying them a lot. They are cinnamon sugar churros from Spain to South Korea to you. These look so good. I love churros. I haven't had a fresh churro in forever, but the crunchy version is pretty tasty too. Ooh, what is this? This is a chocolatey snack cake, soft cake with a fluffy cream filling. That's pretty cool. I mean, this is so soft. Ooh, I like that they sent an item like that. And then we do have some more sweet and sour trues, but this time they are strawberry flavored. It says the king of winter fruits. There are a couple more items in the box, but next up is going to be some choco hazelnut wafer cookies, crispy and creamy wafers with a nutty twist. I personally really like hazelnut, so I'm excited to see more wafer cookies. I feel like the foreign wafer cookies are almost always so much better than the ones that you get in the United States. Ooh, okay, so this is going to be a spicy item. Sweet and spicy tubes. I'm not even going to be able to pronounce that name. Crunchy snacks inspired by Korean rice cakes. Okay, these look like they are going to be very spicy. So this is the actual name of them, but I already know I am not going to be able to pronounce that word right there. So we'll continue on with definitely a favorite. So I have had these before. They were amazing. These are maple flavored corn puffs, South Korea's fountain of youth. I remember opening these the first time I got them and I like dented the whole bag, which was actually pretty bad. And I remember I wanted to repurchase them. That's how good they were. These were amazing. And this next item I've also had previously before too, and I didn't think I'd be too excited about them, but as soon as I opened them, I dented the bag once again. These are Choco Corn Puffs. They're cocoa and coconut puffs, and they were so tasty. They do kind of taste like Cocoa Puffs in a way, I'm not going to lie, but they were really, really tasty. And last up is something super unique. So this is a grape soft drink with coconut jelly. It's the Super Yum's first ever drinkable yum. They have never sent a drink before in their box, so it's actually really cool that they do have this. I know at one point they did have where you can add on a drink in your box. I'm not sure if they still do that, but it is really exciting to see this. I'm guessing this was only in the Super Yum's box, so unfortunately if you did get a smaller box, you would not get to try this. But it's actually really cool to see a new twist to something in the box. And then typically Universal Yums does have a little yum bag with tiny candies in it, but this month they did not do that. I don't know if it's because they have the drink instead or maybe they just sent larger items. But anyway, that is going to bring me to the end of this unboxing, and I am very excited about this box. I feel like this is definitely more on the sweet side, whereas some months they have more of like the chips and the savory snacks, but I'm very happy about this box. I think the South Korea box is going to be amazing. I think I want to dive into absolutely everything, but I would love to know your thoughts. So please comment down below and let me know what you thought of this box. If you subscribed to this box, what was the best item that you tried? I would love to hear any and all of your thoughts, but thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video.